Biodiesel is one example under the larger umbrella of what we might call green chemistry, of a way to make our entire lives safer and healthier. My name is Richard Parnas. I'm a professor of chemical engineering here at the University of Connecticut. And in the last few years, we've developed a biodiesel reactor here. We use waste vegetable oil that we collect from the dining services here at the University of Connecticut. First, right at this point here, is where we're combining the vegetable oil with the methanol. And then it goes through here, and this is actually a mixer here. And it goes in here, and then it very slowly, over a period of about 20 minutes, flows up the length of the reactor. While it's flowing up the length of the reactor, there's a chemical reaction going on that converts the vegetable oil and methanol to biodiesel and another byproduct called glycerol. The molecules of glycerol agglomerate together and form little droplets, and they're heavier than the biodiesel, and so they separate from the biodiesel and fall down to the bottom, just like oil and vinegar salad dressings separate. What is unique about this reactor here, and the reason we have a patent on it, it gives a much better performance for separating out that glycerol, and we don't need a special separation step as is used in most other processes.
When we do a one reactor run, we run it for 10 hours or so. One thing that we're looking into in the laboratory now is to clean up the glycerol so that it is much easier to dispose of.
We're also interested in quality control. We're able to take a probe from a Raman spectrometer and put it into the stream coming out the top of our reactor, and on a second-by-second basis analyze the composition of that stream. And then we take our product over to our shuttle buses, mix it with the petroleum diesel to help run the shuttle buses around the university.
We're working with both the university and private investors to raise the capital to put up a commercial scale.
Biodiesel has about 30% of the carbon footprint of the petroleum diesel. In fact, ASTM grade biodiesel is so non-toxic, you can actually drink it. Now, you wouldn't drink a bottle of olive oil, but you use it in your cooking. Biodiesel is that level of safety.